Our nurses, Josie and Mike, will be meeting with Marcia, a 40-year-old RN who's been intubated by a nurse practitioner. She came in because she was experiencing excessive thirst, excessive urination, and episodes of a very insatiable hunger. The nurse practitioner prescribed metformin and glyburide, and the patient wants to know why she just can't put a few sugar and baking soda. And our worry objectives will be that our client will explain increased symptoms of hypoglycemia and then low constipation. Client will state what adverse reactions to the working healthcare provider. Client will also verbalize the medication that's in use at the end of the consultation. And the client will explain the dangers of comfort alcohol use by the end of our consultation. And one more to state that our client will state drug actions of metformin and glyburide by the end of
Hi, Marcia. I'm Mike.
Hello.
I'm a student nurse here at the clinic, and I'm here to help you understand how the drugs metformin and glyburide work and how it's safe to use.
I don't want to know how to use them. I just want to know why I have to use them. And as far as I'm concerned,
I have type 2 diabetes, and so I'm wondering why I can't just cut out sugar and soda after I have to do it with that one. Well, it sounds like you understand the major indicator of diabetes, which is excessive amount of sugar in the bloodstream, but added sugars like you get in soda are only one source of dietary sugar. There are also sugars that occur naturally in other foods.
Oh, so we're
Yes. So if you were to cut out all the sweets, for example, Cinnabons or Caramel Macchiatos, the body will still convert other foods you eat that have carbohydrates, such as bread, pasta, food, vegetables into glucose also, because your cells need it for energy. In fact, even meat is converted to glucose sometimes. And by the way, glucose is the only source of energy your brain cells need. With type 2 diabetes, many of your cells won't accept other medication where the practitioner prescribed is Lyrica. And it works in a couple of ways. It stimulates insulin receptors and target cells just like metformin does. But Lyrica also stimulates pancreas to produce more insulin. Yeah, that's Lyrica's specialty.
So what about side effects?
Lyrica's side effects are dizziness, headaches, constipation, photosensitivity, hypoglycemia, and I'll explain what that is in a second, and also a metallic taste in your mouth. Of the two drugs you're receiving, Lyrica is the one with the potential to cause hypoglycemia. And that's a life-threatening condition when blood glucose levels drop below 70 milligrams per deciliter. Other serious potential adverse effects of Lyrica are aplastic anemia, unusual weight gain, shortness of breath, swelling of ankles, muscle cramps, and unusual fatigue. If you experience a pattern of those symptoms, you should contact the medical care provider right away. Now, just like metformin, consuming alcohol while using Lyrica is not good, but even more serious.
exercise is important, you're going to want to get 30 minutes, 5 days a week. So if you're having, with exercise, you're going to want to make sure you have snacks along with you so that you don't get hypoglycemic and have an episode. So some snack bars, take some glucose tabs with you, and make sure you're staying very well hydrated while you're working out. Super important. And if you feel like this is a struggle to eat healthy, we actually have an